Hey everybody, thanks for joining us. Today we're going on a juvenile tarpon fishing adventure to the enormous mangrove flats of Campeche, Mexico on the Yucatan Peninsula. We'll catch some amazing hard-fighting tarpon, see a little of the historical city, plus visit one of the incredible Mayan ruins that's close by. So stay tuned.
I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. The city of Campeche lies in the heart of an enormous saltwater flat that extends for miles into the Gulf of Mexico. Along the shoreline exists the second largest mangrove forest in the New World, home to an incredible population of juvenile tarpon that are atop many serious anglers' bucket lists of sport fish. These tarpon move in and out of the dense, unspoiled mangroves with the fluctuating tide, growing strong before returning to the open sea to become adults. The mangroves provide habitat for many species of crabs and small bait fish on which tarpon feed, and when feeding tarpon show themselves, the game begins.
What they do is they'll come out here out of these mangroves and then show themselves and roll out here. Then they go back in again. They go way back into the mangroves. Good cast there, come on, baby. They're in there. Oh, fish on!
In!
The outdoor writer Stan Fagerstrom once referred to juvenile tarpon as aquatic dynamite. And
good
Roy
ice,
Clark
Nico.
Of
good
Clark's
ice.
Outdoor Sporting Adventures has come to Campeche to experience the thrill of hunting and fighting these amazing fish.
Excellent! This is mangrove king, my friend.
Yeah, good ice, eh?
No?
See him rolling out there.
Roy is with Puma Rodriguez, who operates Mangrove King, which provides the ultimate juvenile tarpon fishing experience in Campeche.
Get him out of there, eh?
Throw down.
See? Get him out of the trees. Nice fish.
Yes. Oh!
Man, I love it when they jump like that, eh? This is an average-sized tarpon here for this area. They get up to over 15 pounds.
Wow!
15 to 20 pounds sometimes these fish will run. Nice fish. Okay, Puma, you ready?
Very good.
Okay, when they lay on their side, that's when they're done. He's not ready yet, not on his side yet.
Okay.
About ready.
Beautiful, huh?
Yeah, look at that. See how they lay on their side? That's when they're done. Beautiful.
Oh, beautiful.
Nice tarpon. First one of the trip. That's beautiful,
yes.
Eh?
Beautiful. This is the mangrove king.
Campeche is not only a natural wonder, but it also lies in the heart of a region with an incredible history. Campeche was once guarded from attack by several forts, complete with moats and drawbridges. For over 150 years, Campeche was ravaged by the best pirates and buccaneers in the business, such as Sir Francis Drake, the ruthless Captain Harry Morgan, and the unlucky but dangerous Bartholomew Portuguese. One pirate ship after another attacked the city, but through it all, its citizens maintained their culture and sense of pride. But by the late 17th century, they did get fed up with being attacked by pirates and began to fortify the city with an over 1.5 mile long wall that completely surrounded the main city and included 8 guard posts. Today, the front door, or the sea gate as it's called, transports you back in time to a colorful Baroque colonial city full of interesting shops, historical architecture dating back over 500 years, and many restaurants serving excellent food that's much different than the traditional Mexican cuisine found in most other parts of the country. In general, Campeche is different in many ways from other parts of Mexico. It's officially the healthiest city in Mexico, with many of the 250,000 residents taking advantage of the waterfront walkway. And it's no wonder that Campeche is a favorite location for business people from around Mexico, who enjoy hotels like the Hotel Del Mar, which is where guests of Mangrove King stay. In evening, the locals hang out around Independence Park, relaxing in perfect outside temperatures, while enjoying the serenity of this very peaceful city. But you won't always find that same sense of tranquility out on the water.
Very beautiful.
Maybe juvenile tarpon are like the Pirates of the Caribbean, taking advantage of unfocused relaxation. Regardless, they still are.
Get them out of the mangroves.
The real kings of Campeche.
Get them out of the mangroves.
Yo!
Bow to the king.
Because he's the king, my friend.
For information about visiting the beautiful state and city of Campeche, go to campeche.travel. And also go to visitmexico.com for more information about visiting amazing places all over Mexico.
Oh, fish on!
Welcome back to the over 1,000 square miles of unspoiled mangrove forest and juvenile tarpon paradise in the state of Campeche on the Yucatan Peninsula. I'm Justin Wolf. Roy Clark found his first tarpon in a small lagoon on the outer edge of the mangroves, but now we're pushing deep inside the forest, looking for more fish.
Look at the tarpon. Look at him. Look. Yes, see him?
Yes.
See him?
Yes. Because the tide is low and up.
Yeah.
And that, and right now.
Okay.
So the tarpons
come
open.
Out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Low tide.
Uh huh.
And high tide, they'll go way back in again.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's correct.
See him? Yeah. Grand mucho. Look at a snook right here.
Mm-hmm.
These are blank white?
Black. This is a white mangrove.
White mangrove, okay.
Yeah. And the black is...
Way in the back?
Yes. Yeah, you know?
Uh-huh.
Yes. Tarpon. It's a roll cast. Okay, Roy. Strip. Okay. One cast. Good. El primer sábado de mi vida lo pesqué aquí.
There were plenty of tarpon in this backwater, but they seemed a little hesitant to commit. Puma suggested that our leader was too short, with about 9 feet of 30 or 40 pound fluorocarbon being about right. That simple adjustment made all the difference.
okay. Excellent, my friend. Jump. Roll down.
Little guy.
Baby. It's a baby.
Baby.
It's a baby.
I missed him the first time.
Yeah.
Got him that time. They like this red and white, don't they? Uh-oh, get out of there. Get out of there.
Be careful with the...
Careful with everything.
With the mangrove.
See?
Very beautiful, baby.
Yeah.
Megalops Atlanticus little.
Okay. Good job. Bueno.
Oh.
Missed him the first time, but I got him the second time.
Wow.
Bueno. Good hook job, eh?
Yeah.
Right on. Let's let him go.
Excellent. Okay, let's go.
Yep.
Bye, baby.
Right on.
You go with your father and...
Yeah, I see your father. Where's your father at?
Day after day, you can find unlimited new water to fish deep in the mangroves. And it's not just limited to juvenile tarpon. Snook, snapper, and other species patrol the same holes, looking to feed right alongside the tarpon.
I said it's a snapper. I missed a tarpon.
So any given hotspot can kick out a different fish on every cast.
Well, I had a tarpon come in, hit it twice, and I missed him. And the snapper went and stole it. So that tarpon's still there. I'm going to get him. Snapper. Oh, baby tarpon. Baby tarpon, no?
Yeah.
Never jumped. Another baby tarpon. Better hard that time, buddy. Snook. No snook. Crazy in there. Everything has a snook, now a baby tarpon, and a snapper. Same hole.
Campeche is known for its outstanding tarpon fishing, but snook are no less, if not more, abundant. If you'd like to catch snook until your arms fall off, then just let Puma know and he'll be glad to help you out. But we're here to target grande juvenile tarpon, and that's what we're going to do. While fishing with Mangrove King, guests stay at the very nice Best Western Hotel Del Mar, perfectly located in the city of Campeche. We're deep inside the mangroves of Campeche, where we're getting hookups with smaller juvenile tarpon, snook, and snapper. But we're looking for bigger fish, which can be found anywhere in this mangrove jungle. But on this trip, the small bays on the outer edges of the mangroves seem to hold the bigger tarpon.
Yeah. Muy bien, Roy.
Got that one. Bow to the
king.
Bow to the king, baby.
Muy bueno. Te dije, Roy, Juan, two,
took
three.
Me 3 times to get him. We got him. Telling you, these fish got hard mouths, man. You don't set them good, you don't get them, eh? Woo-hoo-hoo. Bueno. Right on. And I had that fish on hit 3 different times. He wanted it, I guess, eh? That's what you call a hungry fish. There's all kinds of fish rolling in the back there. This is awesome. There's some fish in this bay. This is what we came to Campeche for, huh? Mangrove King. Land of the juvenile tarpon. Belito. You've been fishing here a long time, eh? Many years? You know this area really well, huh?
Say. Si.
You know all the mangrove. And your son now. Whoa! Ho, ho, ho. Okay, you ready, Belito?
Say, si, yeah.
Let's land it.
Hey.
We need to get a picture of this one, buddy. Oh, okay?
Okay.
Well, I think I let him rest too much. All right, here we go. Beautiful, yeah, good job. Oh, that's a nice fish. That's a nice one there. Grande.
Muy grande.
Si, si. This area, that's a good one. Right on. There you go. Nothing wrong with that. Beautiful. Right on, Lito. Right here, baby.
Yeah,
right on. Let's go get another one, eh?
Yes. Muy bueno.
Si.
The mangrove-lined flats of Campeche are an enormous ecosystem, alive with things that swim. And with huge populations of bait fish come huge populations of predatory fish and of fish-eating birds, such as neopelagic cormorants and the magnificent frigate bird, so at home gliding through the air, but not so much at home sitting in the mangroves. The flats of Campeche are thought by scientists to have been created roughly 66 million years ago, when an enormous meteor literally flattened much of the Yucatan Peninsula, causing worldwide climate change, which was very bad news for the dinosaurs. After millions of years, the peninsula rebounded, and eventually, the mathematically and technologically advanced Mayan civilization dominated the region. When the Spanish first discovered the Mayan city and temple at Edzna, they called it the House of Gestures, due to the stucco masks that the Spanish thought looked like clown faces, but were actually the faces of Mayan gods. And at the center of it all, the pyramid Cinco Pesos, thought to be purposely designed to echo the sound of a quetzal bird. Perhaps a Mayan priest stood on this spot to communicate with the gods through the bird sounds. Maybe even during or after a match of juego de pelota, played on this court. A game similar to basketball, using a rubber ball, except you can't touch the ball with your hands. Variations of the game are still played in parts of Mexico today. But for the Mayans, this game wasn't always about just having fun. Parts of the goal still stand, a remnant of a time when slaves would play to perhaps please the gods. And afterwards, up to 2,000 Mayan spectators would gather in the grandstands to witness the very important religious ceremony unfolding on the pyramid before them, as the losers of the game would face the Mayan ritual of human sacrifice. For information about visiting the beautiful state and city of Campeche, go to campeche.travel. And also go to visitmexico.com for more information about visiting amazing places all over Mexico. Welcome back to the Yucatan Peninsula. I'm Justin Wolf. We're after the incredibly hard-fighting juvenile tarpon, and here in Campeche, it's sight fishing at its best. Most of the time, you won't cast until you see a fish.
Show strip, Roy. Trip, trip, trip.
Coming.
Tarpon.
Fish on! Oh. Dang it. That was another grande. I seen a wave coming. Dang it. Yeah, with these tarpon, I guess, they're hard mouths, man. When you see a lot of fish, you hook them, but land them is another story. I mean, they got real hard mouths, and you got to line set them. You don't line set them, you don't get them. And you got to bow to the king. When they jump, you push point the rod to them, you don't pull back like every other fish. So it's really a whole different game here.
Just because they're called juvenile tarpon doesn't mean that they're baby fish at all. Tarpon begin their life cycle out at sea and drift towards the mangroves as pelagic fry.
Fish on, big fish, grande!
Developing through a complex series of physical changes until eventually they grow large enough to pursue prey among the mangroves.
Grande!
Juvenile tarpon are actually well along in their life cycle, almost ready to return to the open sea to become full-grown Woo-hoo. Adults, sometimes reaching over 200 pounds.
That was the cast there. Can't keep up with them.
But while they patrol the mangrove flats, they definitely are Yucatan dynamite.
That would cast was right on them. Whoa, yeah. Good eye, Plito. Strong fish here. Oh yeah. Got a bow to the king, baby. Bueno, good set that time, huh? Grande. Oh, it hurt my finger. stripped my line so hard, ripped my finger, burned me. I love it. I love that burn. Not ready yet. Not on the side yet. They'll do this for about 5 or 10 minutes to sit like this next to the boat. You think you got them and you don't. See, they just give up. That's it. When they're on their side like that, you got them. Until then, look out, eh? Nice fish. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Look at that. There's that, that's the tarpon. That's one of the bigger tarpons I've gotten here. This fish will probably go 12 to 14 pounds. This is a nice sized fish in this area. Beautiful.
These bigger fish take a little more longer to revive than the smaller ones.
Gotta let them breathe.
There he goes.
Right on. Got for another day. Right on, Blito. Good eye, buddy. Good job. Right on. That was worth the trip right there, eh? Right on. Good job.
Yeah, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Yeah, here's a little tip, just in case you decide to go fishing with Mangrove King. After a day of fishing, have dinner at the restaurant El Faro del Moro, which is right on the dock. The food is fantastic, and the location couldn't be better.
And also, if you're not a fly fisherman, that's okay. Mangrove King welcomes conventional tackle as well. Small jigs, rip baits, and topwater plugs can be highly effective. So whether you're fly casting or using conventional gear, you'll find the juvenile tarpon to be one of the world's great light tackle sport fish species.
Bow to the king, baby.
For more information, visit Mangrove King online at mangroveking.mx. And also visit campeche.travel. a website full of information about traveling to Campeche. And go ahead and call Roy Clark today to book a fishing adventure to juvenile tarpon paradise. Okay, thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing. For information about visiting the beautiful state and city of Campeche, go to campeche.travel. And also go to visitmexico.com for more information about visiting amazing places all over Mexico.